This week's installation of Archbishop Wilton Gregory as Archbishop of Washington, D.C., the first African-American to be appointed, brings with it a new beginning.
Our recent sorrow and shame do not define us. Rather, they serve to chasten and strengthen us to face tomorrow with spirits undeterred.
The 71-year-old Gregory served previously as the Archbishop of Atlanta. He becomes the seventh Archbishop of Washington. Joining me now to give his opinion on the new Archbishop is James Grein. James has admitted publicly that he was sexually abused at a young age by one of the former Archbishops of Washington, Theodore McCarrick. James, after Theodore McCarrick was defrocked, Pope Francis accepted the resignation of Cardinal Donald Worrell. How do you feel now that we have a new archbishop who says he wants to talk to survivors, be active in the community?
Well, it's a very big positive step forward. You know, it's a great opportunity for the African-American Catholic here in the diocese to really step forward and feel united together. And I believe that we are going to have a new chance in Washington, D.C.
You've talked on the program before about the trauma that you felt after the sexual abuse experience and how it impacted your life. What do you say to other victims of clergy sex abuse who have feel like they've lost direction in their life and may still be struggling?
I believe telling them all the time is that the church that abused us were men. And my church is Jesus Christ. And you have to remain faithful to Jesus. And you need to pray every single day. Fast as often as you can and meditate. And that's what I do on a daily basis. And it has helped me greatly. And so I have a group of people now that I talk to on a regular basis who are struggling with that. And it's been actually a gift for me, so that gets me out of myself a little bit more to help somebody else, which is, you know, tremendous.
Your faith has inspired you to help those who are less fortunate. You recently traveled to Thailand to volunteer to help farmers there. Tell me about what the situation was like there and why you wanted to go.
Well, I wanted to go because I needed to be distracted from all the mess that was sitting in my head. I was tremendously distracted by all the trauma that I'd been living, and I needed to go someplace else. And the year prior to this, I had met a young lady in Bangkok, and she was a farmer. And she helped me buy something, and because she knew Thai and she knew English. She says, you should come out to my house. I don't live in Bangkok, I live up in the farm country. And I went there, and this whole community was struggling because there wasn't enough water. And they never had a break, and they live on pennies a day. And I thought to myself, I said, well, let's try to dig a well. Let's try to dig a well, maybe we can get 90 acres of land back into a usable situation. The man who had been working on this land for 37 years was sad. He was thinking he was going to lose his farm to some corporate America or corporate Thai or corporate European situation. And he was holding on for dear life. So we started to dig a well, and we went down 35 meters. We struck water, but the water was no good. And they got sad. And I said, well, we got to keep going. We're not stopping here.
And so thanks to your efforts, you were able to drill, I believe you told me, two wells?
Two wells. And it's covering 90 acres of land. And they're planting corn, they're planting rice, they're planting fruit trees, they're doing everything. There is a new hope. So this farm impacts 500,000 people.
Just one example of you trying to volunteer to help others because of you being inspired by your faith. James Grein, thank you for sharing your story. I'm sure there's many clergy sex abuse survivors who appreciate your efforts.
Thank you, Wyatt.